Hi everybody, it's Carole. So today I'm going to do a strainer pour. I've got two strainers. I'm going to put one here and see what happens. First I'm going to mix up a couple of paints. I just wanted to show how I mix my paint. I'll just do one color. I'm using DecoArt Metallic Amethyst, and Metallic Red Artist Loft Tube. So this is a craft paint, I would call it. It's a little bit thinner than the tube paint. So my floetrol, this is floetrol that I use. I'll turn it this way, I guess. And I give it a shake. So there's about an ounce of paint in there. Sometimes I put this in a smaller container, but I haven't today. So an ounce of this, I only put a half an ounce of floetrol. This tube paint, I would do 1:1. The Artist Loft Flow Acrylic, I would do the same as the craft paint, about 1/2 to 3/4. All right, so here it goes. So there's an ounce of paint. I'll just put in a half an ounce. So it's my little measuring cup, says an ounce of paint, and then I'd go up to 1.5. A little stick. And I give it a good stir. And it's quite runny already. Something in there. So for a strainer pour, you don't need it too runny. Not like a blowing pour or a Dutch pour or a cloudy pour. So I'm going to let it so that there's a little bit of a, I'm going to add a little water just so that there's a small puddle and it disappears. Still a big puddle. It's pretty good now. It's a steady stream. Strainer pour, you don't want it too thin or it'll just all run into each other. That's pretty good. Nice steady stream off there. A small puddle. I think that's good. So this is the tube paint, so I'm going to put an ounce in here. I'll do this 1:1, so I'll take it up to 2. It doesn't have to be perfect, as long as it's close. There's no steadfast rule. So I can already feel how much thicker this is, but once I start to mix this up, crazy dryer's terrible noise. I'll be back. All right, I turned my dryer off. Okay, so this is still thick. So this is where you add your water. Just add it a bit at a time. use distilled water. Okay, a little bit more water, and we're good. All right, I'll be back, and there, it's pretty good now. All right, I'm back, just spreading around my white paint. It's just Artist Loft Flow Acrylic with Floetrol. Mix the same as my black, so it's not quite 1-to-1 ratio. This doesn't have to be perfect, it's going to be all covered over. It's just to help it flow. At the sides later. Okay, so I'm going to put my strainers down. I just thought I would try two different ones just to see what effects I get. Bring this one in a bit. Okay, so I got red, purple, they're both metallic. I have some cerulean blue, just a little bit. I think that's all the colors I'm going to use. Sometimes metallics are thicker than the regular paint, so just check it. Make sure. And I think I'll start with purple. In here so you can see the there. All right, start with a bit of purple. Whoa. Take this one off. See if I can move this around a bit. I should have did four. Should have done four. This is an experiment. See if I can get it to come down the other way. I could have added more paint, but I was... Oh, it's different. It's different, but it's pretty with those metallics. Thank you. bubble there. Ooh. Oh, I like those little cells. Well, how would this look with a balloon smash? What do you think? Okay, I'm gonna let it sit for a bit and see what happens, and I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. I just thought I would try and put some lines with my palette knife. See if I could get some kind of a flower design, but. So. So I'm going to do a balloon smash. Because it was an experiment, and this is going to be another experiment. So why not? If you don't try these things, you'll never know. I did a spiral pour. Spiral pours are awesome for balloon smashes. So you could do a spiral pour and then just do a balloon smash, and it just makes such nice designs. So we'll see what this does. Not sure if it's too wet, but we'll try. I'll put one right in the middle. Woo. Pretty. Taking it away from that little bump because I think it made it too big there, but. looking its own flowers around. I need one right there. I don't like that one very much. Let's see if I can do that. I can get a little more yellow in there. Oh, I guess I pushed the yellow down into the middle. There. I think that looks kind of pretty. I should go over that one again. Okay, well. Okay, sorry this took so long, but there, how's that? I'm gonna torch it. I think it's pretty. All right, so there we go. My strainer pour turned into a balloon smash. So, note to self, put more paint on when you're doing a strainer pour so that you don't have to tilt it too much. Okay, thanks for coming by and check out our Facebook group. There's a link in the description below my video. If you look below my video, you'll see some links. Please subscribe if you haven't already. Like, thumbs up, like is like, and hit the bell for notifications. You'll get a new video. You'll get a notification when I do a new video. That's when you subscribe, okay? Have a great day. and come back soon to my art room. Bye-bye.